about this inspiring bear story that you've been working on for us this week?
Yeah, it centres around a lady. Now, this lady is at an age where you'd be expecting her to slow down and really think about retirement. She's 71. Her name's Mary Hutton, and she's just decided to follow her passion. And her passion is helping animals that can't defend themselves. Now, this is her story. It's amazing.
We have had bears come in. They've been in terrible conditions. They were hog-tied, absolutely terrified and traumatised. So every bear that we save, we look on it as a bonus.
Mary Hutton was living a quiet life in Perth, contemplating retirement, when she saw these images and decided she had to do something. Now, 15 years on, Mary's Free the Bears Fund has rescued more than 700 sun and Asian black bears from horrific conditions in Southeast Asia and India.
I've seen where two bears have been kept in cages where they were going to take the bile for the gallbladder. I've seen bears come in the dancing bear trade in India where these bears have a rope through their nose and these bears have been crying in pain. But slowly, with rehabilitation and good vet skills, we've been able to bring those bears back to give them a good quality, a second chance of life.
It's been a long 18 months since Mary last visited the bears at her Cambodian sanctuary. Needless to say, they're excited to see her.
When I get the opportunity to come in and see the bears and have a little rumble with them, it's very rewarding. But to see the whole sanctuary and all the bears healthy, that's my reward, really, just to see them well and happy. Oh, no, back to me again. Another great big bite.
Two people who have seen Mary's work at the sanctuary firsthand are Rove McManus and Tasma Walton.
Seeing all these bears that had previously lived such an atrocious life and now being able to even walk around, to be able to stand up.
We saw how intelligent these animals are, how emotional they are, and they suffer real trauma in being captured, being kept in bile farms. You know, they suffer real torture and agony.
We met one beautiful little sun bear who was missing a paw, because to catch these bears, they'll often use snares.
Holly was found in a restaurant in Persat, which is down in the southwest of Cambodia. She'd lost her back paw being captured in a snare, and she was being held in a restaurant, obviously, for a rich customer to come along and order bear paw soup or bear meat or any other kind of food like that.
While she's lost one of her paws, these days Holly gets along just fine without it.
And they just like cuddles. They like human interaction as well, because they know they're well looked after, they know they're going to be treated kindly, plenty of food. So, 5-star accommodation, actually.
It costs $2,000 a year to feed and house just one rescued bear. But the end result is priceless.
These guys have all got their own individual horror stories behind them, and we really don't want any of these bears in captivity. They shouldn't be here in the first place.
It would be great to think that, you know, there could come a time where bears can just be bears in Asia.
You have to keep going, and that makes you feel better because you're knowing you're doing something positive, but you never stop feeling for the bears and you never stop having that compassion.
To think that one person actually followed up on that desire to make change, and it worked. I say good on you, Mary Hutton.
Incredible, isn't it? Oh, now, Mary is turning 72 this year.
Right.
Now, rather than resting on her success in the past, she's in Lao right now, and the word we just got through is that she's saved another 5 cubs, which is amazing.
Well, if you want more info on Free the Bears or to help Mary out with the course, just head to our website. All the details are there too.